Welcome, dear friends of Tactical Gameplay. I am Dagar, and this is Xenonauts X Division mode. We're looking at the next mission. I skipped the whole we fly to the mission and we drop all our stuff phase, and the only thing I want to do in the first round is to check our vicinity a bit for any aliens that might be here, but so far it's looking pretty good, I think. Yeah, okay. So this should suffice for me. I will spread the guys out a bit here, and just so we are less vulnerable to grenade tossers. And yeah, that essentially should be it for the first round. Okay, apparently someone with a shotgun shot this guy. So there is an alien right around this corner, I think. Let's go there and investigate. There is a farmer. And the alien is in... Oh, it's here. Okay. So this is enormous civilian. I missed checking what kind of alien we already have, so I'll just assume for now that... Oh! We already have this one. This one is suppressed, which is pretty cool. So maybe let's see if we can suppress him a bit more. Yeah, obviously the car is in the way. But we should be able to drive it there and shoot in this direction to suppress him a bit more. Which, now that I'm thinking about this, isn't even a thing. This is like a myth I thought was true. But... So what suppression really does is, for this turn, the turn the suppression is applied in, it takes all of your time units, and for the turn afterwards it halves your available time units. So that's essentially all there is. Yeah, so this civilian still will have half his time units. I'm not sure if he can see the scout car. I think it's reasonable to believe so. So maybe the car will get hit a bit. One salvo should theoretically be possible. Yeah, so I want to bring the shielders up, obviously. Oh, I have to... increased brightness of my screen here. So I'd prefer if we had this as the main spearhead direction. So we'll try to do so. He shouldn't be able to toss a grenade, at least. And I'll have one shielder and one MG in this direction, which should be fine. And I just hope that no one's back there. Okay, there's one shot. It's a ballistic gun, which is cool. We might be able to use it. And now he's not suppressed anymore, but he shouldn't have any kind of time units left after the shot to actually do anything. So, what are our hit chances? Zero here because of the hedge. What would be the hit chances for this tile? 13%. Or 40 if we took the most accurate shot. So maybe we are able to blow up the hedge there. We'll see. Like this. Well, it kind of worked, I think. Yeah, we see the alien, but now I'm not too sure why our hit chances are lower. Maybe because it's going through two hatch tires. But then again, as far as I've read, the first obstacle of the highest kind is the one that's really blocking. So this might not be the case. Okay, he's suppressed. So now we should be able to get closer. I want some kills on my guys instead of the armored car if I can help it. And use the car more for the scouting that's already in its name. If I were to go back here, he shouldn't be able to see me, I hope. And this would give us the opportunity to get out there next turn. And he's actually blocking the corpse there, so we can pick up his gun. But this should be alright. So, can you shoot at him? No, perfect, okay. You are going to crouch. You are going to check the vicinity for a bit. Okay, nothing here so far. So we'll go back here and look in this direction. So the MG fire can has less chance to suppress him here. And we'll have the rest of the troops move up a bit. Yeah, he still shouldn't be able to throw a grenade. So we should be fine back here. And the scout car should be invisible here, I think. I'm not 100% sure. Well, at least it's blocking. So we'll see what goes there. Okay. He comes out of his corner there. And he should have spent all his time units again. So we'll see if we can maybe kill him with a trooper. Perfect. Draku did the kill shot. Charon can now take a look at the weaponry here. Ballistic rifle, which is cool. I'll take this. And I'll drop a bit of other stuff for it. And also take the grenade. I just like the alien weapons. I mean, they're less accurate, but they pack a much bigger punch, so there's that at least. The scout car will be ready to look around the corners next turn. Potato should now take a position where he can suppress anything from this direction, so we'll go like here. Maybe have another look around, okay. And at the same time, he as we can see in there exactly now, he also shouldn't be visible. Okay, Patrick Murray has his first mission here, his premiere. And Sabine Drängen, well, we'll pick up the other alien weapon next turn. As I said, I'm a big fan of the alien weaponry. At least as long as it's no flame weaponry. Did this one get shot right now? I don't think so. But someone did. Okay, no one there. I think we'll keep the troops rather concentrated and move into this direction now. Who do we have here? Draku, who did the kill shot. You can also... Oh, it's a sniper actually. Okay, change of plans. Wilder will. No, actually, no one will take the sniper because the accuracy penalty you get from A in weapons, which I think at least is a thing, should make it rather infeasible to take the A in sniper. So we'll have a look around here. There's the bleeding farmer guy. Farrelly will come here, our sniper will come here. And the scout now will have a look in this direction. Okay, there is a dead farmer and a live farmer. Oh, and there is a civilian. Okay, so change of plans again. These guys are gonna close in on him from this direction. And we'll just try to suppress him here. And head back in. Oh, and there's the UFO. And head back into our cubby, I wanted to say here. So, as far as I know, Charon said that the aliens listen to our footsteps, so if I decide to come here, they should know that we're there, but at the same time, if this one is going to stand up and come around the corner, he shouldn't be able to shoot at us. So, we'll play it kinda conservatively, because we are using an adverb here. Gotta watch the language always. Yeah, we're gonna see if we can close up on him. This should be blocked, this should be blocked. Or can you shoot there? No, you can't. This should be open, but that's okay. And Charon will go here, in case the alien really comes around this corner here. Draco will stay there, and these guys won't advance any further for now. I'm actually considering throwing a smoke here, but no one has the time, so we'll just leave it be there. It seems to me the alien shot at the farmer there, but we'll know for certain now. Don't kill him! Yeah, just suppress him. So now we have him suppressed. We did more damage than he should heal in one turn, I think. But the good thing is we should be able to line up now in his back, so we can club him next turn. So we should bring in as many guys as possible. He can't throw a grenade now, because of the suppression. Grenades cost like 55% of your time units, and he only has 50. So there's that. With 5 guys with clubs, this should be okay, I hope. It should be feasible to club him next turn. Put the scout car back. If the sniper crouch here, what actually can you see? Okay, you can see kind of in there, which is good. Shielder will come back and we'll leave it at that. Maybe Farrelly will have another look around. As far as we know, there might be Reapers somewhere around the map. Okay, this farmer wasn't shot at least. And someone or something moved through some kind of hedge. Ah, he stood up again. So, we try to bring him down once more? Yes, okay. And now is the age of clubs. Oh, no! What? Stop. Ah, damn it. Okay, that was unfortunate. I thought this tile was walkable, but it apparently isn't. So we'll have to see if we can even manage now and save some time unit from the guys with the sticks. Six here. Okay, let's do it. Let's take the stick in hand and stick it to him. Okay, Charon won't do another beating. Oh, and Draco doesn't have a stick. Okay, so what we can do here is drop Charon's stick, have Charon move, and have Draco pick it up. And have another one at him. Okay, perfect. So all we gotta do is now is pick back up our weapons, get into some kind of cover towards the UFO and this entry here, because we don't know what there is. Draco will leave that here, walk back to his weapon, take it up and be vulnerable, and our shielder guy can't move, so we're gonna bring someone there who can throw a smoke grenade. Maybe Private Solberg can. How far can you throw a sun? Okay. 28 was right. Yeah. Okay, well, that's at least something. Ah, that was a bit short. Which means that it was utterly useless. Farrelly should be able to deploy another smoke from around here. And we're pretty much banking on no alien coming from there right now. Okay, this is better. Okay, it's good. Good grenade. So Charon can pick up his stick again, pick it in his put in it in his belt. Bloop. And Potato can pick up the MG and come to this hedge. And Patrick Murray can't do shit. Does he have his pistol yet in hand? No, it's somewhere around there. Okay. So Filda will actually throw a smoke here and then back away. Can you? Can you? You can't because there's a farmer. Okay. So take cover behind the civilian shield. Okay, so this is that. Bring the scout car up a bit. And then we'll end the turn. Oh, the farmer actually bled out. Maybe we could have saved him with a bandage, but I didn't think to do so on time. Ah. Come on, is your pistol there at least? Yes, it is. So, more delays. I feel like Deutsche Bahn right now. And we'll just spread out a bit. And have Svinedringen check what this guy has. Also a sniper. Okay, and he is a weapon sergeant. So we can mark that one on our list, as long as we don't blow up the corpse or the incapacitated alien body. And we'll have these guys stay Oh, he actually splattered, which is kind of funny. Okay, so we will just have a look into this direction and storm this breach first. Now that I think of about it, actually I'd love to have someone with them, some more riflemen. Because they are pretty underrepresented here. And there are some aliens on the map still, which is no surprise. Okay, so we have a barn here. Crouching civvy there. Bring up the MG. We'll bring up the sniper a bit. It's not a perfect position for her right now. Ah, she has a pistol actually. We might consider taking the pistol in hands. Just because it's more practical in these kinds of distances. And we'll bring Charon up a bit. Have Tor move back and throw a smoke grenade here. Like that. Perfect accuracy. Nice. Okay, so let's take a look at the scout car in this direction. There is at least a blood spot on the ground. You can't look around this edge. Or this, yeah, whatever. Okay, so no one to be seen here, no windows in this direction, only these doors. There is the civvy again. No one back here as far as we can see. Okay, so it looks reasonably clear, but we'll order our troops here a bit, just to be safe. And then we'll, as soon as this building here is safe, we can take these guys around here and stone the UFO. Okay, so this was a patch of high grass. It could have been the farmer guy here, maybe. No, he's still hiding there, so it was something else. And it clearly wasn't in this building, because buildings shouldn't have grass in them. There is another farmer, okay. So, since we didn't hear any shootings in the last rounds, this should mean that a reasonably large portion of this building is actually clear. But it doesn't... it's just a hypothesis, so to say. It's not 100% sure. Okay. You should actually park yourself like this. A sniper here would be... Oh no, it wouldn't be good because of all the trees, but on this side of the building I could imagine Fedda actually doing something with a sniper rifle. And the rest of the guys will just stay put like this with the... with the exception of the scout car, who should do some more scouting just to be safe. Okay. Still no shooting in the farmhouse or whatever. Okay. So there could still be an alien hiding in some of these corners or whatnot. So we'll actually stay a bit careful. There's another civilian. and we'll watch this door especially. Filda will take her main weapon back in hands. And I'd wish for this guy not to be there, so we could have a rather clear line of sight here. But then again, there are that many trees which we can waltz down into. So where did the grass sound come from? That's the question. You will come to this corner. There might be something back here actually, now that I think about it. But first of all we'll check the door. And look inside. So there's nothing here, right? Okay, another door there. And the farmer went somewhere back there. So at least we know this. So do I risk putting Charon there? I apparently did. Okay, so Farrelly will come here. The farmer's back on his position. And we'll have Farrelly look in here, because if the farmer encounters something, we'll know it. Another look here, but I'm pretty certain that if there is another A and it's somewhere here, and something in the UFO for sure. But at least we don't ever hear the door. Nothing here so far. We'll have a look inside here. Nothing. And we'll... Oh! It has an upper floor. So we'll prepare for some kind of an ambush there. We'll bring Charon back here to assist. And have Farrelly look in this direction. Okay. And we just have to hope that no one is walking past us here. Because that's a... Well, maybe actually we could put Filda here. Just to watch our backs. Because this alley isn't terribly important right now. Oh! The whole field is burning up there. from our one grenade, and some other farmer guy just... it seems... got... down for his wounds. Do we have a flashbang? I don't usually use them, but in this case they actually might be good. I will just risk it. Okay, I need to see what's actually up here. How far can we walk? This is the outer edge, okay. So... there are some black spots on our map still. But not anymore now. Okay. So we cleared the whole building, it seems. And we can now go on to storm the UFO. And we'll bring Filda up now. You had some line of sight towards the UFO in there, but it's exactly the kind of position where you don't have it anymore. Do you have a line of sight? Yes, you do. Okay. Cool. So this is a reasonably good sniper position, as long as we can gain line of sight there, which we'll do next turn, I think. Not now. Okay, none of these two. Oh, another whatever going through grass. Which, to be honest, is pretty scary for me. Because I don't know what it is. So, oh, okay, the car blocks everything here, seems. This could be a mistake, I don't know. I don't know yet, but you'll look in this direction. And we'll have Potato come up here. Put the scout car kind of behind the trees here. And maybe lay some fire in front of the door. But he can't, okay. So we'll just try to stay ready in case something puts his head out there. And then we'll have to have Patrick and one rifleman, I think, check the back of the UFO. Sharon can do it, kind of. But he'll also have to make sure it doesn't get shot. So nothing here. If this farmer could go away so I can could put an MG there, that would be perfect. And as far as we can see, no one is back here. And we can see pretty much everything. So I'm wondering where the grass sounds come from. Maybe from the fire back here. Fire can't spread here, I hope, because I don't want to lose that body. Can the scout caster shoot? It can. But it is blocked by the forest. And as soon as we move up, we lose the time units to shoot. So we'll just let it be for now. And maybe throw a smoke grenade up there, because we should have enough of them. Just to also make sure our guys are safe. Okay, so in the next turn we'll have Patrick come back here. Filda and what's his face, Farrelly. Cover the door from the long direction and the others stack up here and then we'll enter. Okay, he's even making space for us, which is nice. So, Murray, your time to shine. Oh, we actually have the other shielder back here, which I forgot in the last couple of turns, I think. Potato maybe should have stayed here, but we can also do this with Swinedrängen, who is last in line anyway. To kind of cover this direction. We have the scout car come up and suppress the door, not breaking it. Okay, we didn't. And hide back behind the forest there. You are actually able to shoot, which is cool. So please do. And Sharon should be reasonably safe back here. I'm not too fond of leaving him alone here, but then again we can always walk around the back of the UFO. Yes, reasonably good fire support here, and the aliens on the front door, should there be any, are suppressed. So now, let's move closer to the front door and prepare storming it, it being the UFO. And I think I'll actually put Sharon rather here. Fairly will crouch down and then we'll see what ensues here. We'll bring the scout car up, watch down the tree, again at the door, hopefully not suppressing any of our own, and then just drive out of the way. We still have the shielder back here, actually. Ah, damn it, I forgot. Okay, we'll bring him up. And the rest of the guys will just wait. Scout car still has reasonably good amounts of ammo. Oh, we hit something. Or at least suppressed it. Or Solberg will come here, Charon behind him. And then we'll suppress them once more now. And then whether it being by shooting at it or whatever. Okay, so there are normal soldiers in there. The one in the back not being suppressed yet. What are your chances to suppress him actually? Negligible. So we'll do this. Then we'll come up and execute the first. Or not. Who else can try to do that? You'll come back. Maybe I'll snap actually. 50 something. Huh, go for it. Okay. Shooting the dead dude. Still not dead. So you'll get back to cover, you'll come up and do the same. Okay. So we have this one dude back there suppressed. And it might be that there's some other alien in there. We have the alien grenade still, but I'm pretty sure we won't need it. And we'll put smoke here, just for our own safety. And see what ensues. Okay. So he still has half of his hit points left, of his time units. So we'll actually go and suppress him. And our own guys, which is fine in this state. Have the Tor come up, have a look in there. Nothing as far as we can see. Charon also sees nothing. So this is the only dude left. And we're pretty golden here. We can stack up our guys behind the shields. And then we'll rush in next turn. Maybe with clubs drawn, we'll see. So we could come up here, suppress the close range, which means that I'm losing my wording here. Which means that he can shoot back, and we can try clubbing him now. And if not, we should have the MG ready to kill him, which should be feasible from this distance. So, Swinedrängen, I think you're the one. No, you actually have a club. You can find me in the club. Okay. Can you get back out, kind of? So we'll have our first guy cornered in the UFO, but that's okay. It's okay. It's fine. No! You shouldn't shoot. You should clap him. Okay. So who else can clap? Tor can definitely clap the alien. This should cost the least amount of points. Okay. Perfect. Swinedrängen is injured because I took him on the mission in this state. Filler once again didn't do much apart from missing her only shot because I can't deal with snipers, and we actually didn't have the weapon sergeants yet. Okay. Weapon sergeants should bring something with weapons, obviously. So this is good, but we'll do the Elenium first. And we also severely lack in terms of research right now. Can I actually relocate the AWACS to Indochina, please? Just because there's the whatever UFO up there, and I'm still waiting for my aircraft, which I hear now. Okay, so we will launch interceptors towards there, the ones from Indochina, and we'll have a look at whatever's up there, if anything. Oh, they are actually down here, it seems, right now. We should maybe have waited for the AWACS. How much fuel do you have left? Can we see? 52. Okay, return to base. Fuel up for when the AWACS is there. I'm pretty tired still. So we apparently built Mausers. We should consider at least starting on Foxtrots. We have some disassembly, which is cool because it brings us all the good stuff for other aircraft. This isn't interesting right now. This really isn't interesting as well. So we'll just do the disassemblies one after the other. And there the UFO is. Okay. How much fuel do you guys have? 39%. Okay. So you, Squadron 3, select new target, this UFO. Can you get it? You do. 91%, 91 seconds of combat fuel, which is pretty good.
Drawing heavy fire. Coming in at 619.
We'll see which direction it takes. Yep, I assumed it.
Damage report now.
Oh, it actually... No, it doesn't turn around. Okay. Nice. What does it do?
One receiving.
So we'll stay out of its range barely, I hope. Bit of fuel left. We'll actually use the afterburner here for 1 and 2, right. just so we can bridge this gap faster. 3 will continue on its course.
Let's wrap this up.
And these two will now turn off the afterburners. Directly engage the UFO. No, you shouldn't turn back this. And now 3 can come in. And 1 and 2 should roll this direction. These rolls are not too efficient, but okay. Well done. New planes did the right thing immediately. And we still all have all our guys here. We don't have any more new gimmicks, I think. So we can just take the team that's there and apply it to the crash site. And by the time they're there, it should be day. So we'll have another bunch of interceptors there. The ones from Northern Africa, why not? Okay, nothing's there for now. This was at 12:06, this at 13:06, so it could be anywhere, really. And if we go a bit more north, yeah, they'll be out of fuel. So, we have our next mission, and I think it's a good time to make a cut. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and we'll see each other in the next one. See ya!